Hello and welcome to the course DA7650 Advanced Computer Network. We are in Module 3, Lecture 1. Today we will discuss wireless LAN design. This is the part 1 for this lecture. If you are facing any difficulties in understanding this lecture, you are free to post queries in the comment section or during our live session on Microsoft Teams. So let's begin. Before I am discussing the detail of wireless LAN design, let us first discuss why the wireless LAN is so popular. Due to this 3 point, this is popular. One is called flexibility, second one is called increased productivity, and third one is called cost saving compared to the wire development. How it is flexible? Wireless LAN lets users, servers, printers and other network resources, regardless of their location, within the wireless reach. So we can access any wireless devices if we are in the range of that particular device. That is called the flexibility. Another point I want to add here, the flexibility means that, for example, you use your laptop in your home, either in your bedroom, you can use it in your drawing room, or you can use it in your kitchen. If you are in the range of your wireless network, then you can easily use your laptop and work on your laptop anywhere. But if you go out from your room and your wireless device is connected inside your building, then you may not access those facilities. But still, this type of flexibility will be there. The second point is called increased productivity. According to a 2003 NOP World Research Study, wireless LAN users stayed connected to their corporate network 3.64 hours per day, longer than their wired peers. Thus, increasing their productivity by 27%. Though the flexibility of wireless LANs not only does the productivity go up, but the response time are also significantly improved. That's why this production gets increased. The mobility does not stop here at laptop or personal digital assistant. There will be some concepts like IP telephony, video conferencing are also supported over wireless LAN. Integrating quality of service to ensure that the interactive traffic has priority over the less time-sensitive data transfer. Okay, so the final benefit is called the cost saving. So another significant benefit of wireless LAN is that low cost development in locations where the cost of running LAN wire would be prohibitive. Right, that means if somewhere you are not allowed to put your wired LAN, then there you can use your wireless LANs. And somewhere if you think that more wire is needed and the cost is increasing, there you can put your wireless devices. So that is the benefit of cost saving. Okay, so the total cost of ownership of a wireless LAN is very low compared to the benefit they bring to their organization, providing that wireless LAN is secured and managed properly too. Fine? That's why wireless is so popular. Now we will discuss wireless technology overview. So in this part, what we are going to show you that, I'm showing you two things. Wireless LAN is working upon radio frequencies. Okay? So you need to be in the range to access the services. As shown in the figure, there are two devices connected to a network. Two devices forms two network over here. In the first network, I am showing a hub connected to their wired client through wires. And the second one is I am using a wireless access point and no wire is connected between them. You use your wireless clients anywhere in your in your range and can access the services provided by this wireless access point. Okay, but Here another point you should remember, because wireless LANs use RF, the throughput is inversely proportional to the distance between transmitter and receiver. Okay, that is obvious. To explain this, I am using another slide for it. So if you see this figure, this is your wireless device and these are the range or the distance. When you go on increasing the distance, then the speed of data gets decreased. Got it? So if you are in 100 to 150 feet range, then your speed will be 11 Mbps. But if you are 150 to 250 range, then your speed reduced to 5.5 and so on. So that was shown in this figure. However, wireless communication brings a trade-off between flexibility and mobility versus battery life and usable bandwidth. So what does this mean? If you know that, for an example, you are using a mobile phone, and whenever your mobile phone is in the range of your mobile network or mobile tower, then your battery does not drain out so quickly. Think about your wireless access point. You have connected a wireless access point in your home, and if you are inside your home, then the battery life will increase. But when you access those things by taking your mobile to outside the building, then your battery life drains out continuously. Okay, so that is the flexibility, that is called the trade-off between flexibility and mobility versus battery life. Fine. This part I want to discuss here. Then we'll go to discuss on the wireless standards. So what are the different standards has already been developed? Wireless standards that are currently supported by major vendors were developed by the working group 11 of IEEE 802 committee. Okay. So the most common standards are represented over here, or shown over here, that is 802.11b, 802.11a and 802.11g. So the speed, the maximum throughput and frequencies are also given, and in which year they have been actually available in the market, it is also shown. Some point regarding this I want to discuss. So the points are something like that, like this. The 802.11a standard operates in a unlicensed 5 GHz band. Okay, this 802.11a, which makes the transmission vulnerable to interference from microwave oven and cordless phones. The strength of 802.11b and 802.11g signal, which operates in the 2.4 GHz band, is affected negatively by water and metal and thick walls. Okay, they are working on 2.4. The 802.11b and 802.11g standard divides the 2.4 GHz into 14 overlapping individual channels. Channels 1, 6 and 11 do not overlap and therefore can be used to set up multiple networks. The 802.11a is that it suffers less from interference, but it uses its use is restricted to almost line of sights, thus requiring the installation of more access point than 802.11b to cover the same area. Okay, if you think about the medium access method of 8011 standards, any standard, this medium access method is called distribution coordination method. Distribution coordination method, right? And it is similar to the CSMA/CD mechanism of Ethernet. Right? So this is about all about wireless standards. Besides this wireless standard, another two wireless standard is also proposed in 1998, and that is called Home RF, and second one is called Bluetooth. Okay, in 1998 a consortium was formed to promote the idea of Home RF to be used with products in the home market. The participants were, among others, Siemens, Motorola and Compaq. Everybody knows about the Bluetooth technology, so no need to explain all those things. This is a specification of short-range radio links between mobile computers, mobile phones, digital cameras and other portable devices such as headsets. Bluetooth could be considered a standard for personal area network. Okay, this is the standard for personal area network. Fine. So when you are using the wireless network, what actually transmitted between the wireless networks? So there are three frames transmitted among the wireless network. One is called data frame, second one is called control frame, and third one is called manager frame. I'll start by manager frame. So what is manager frame? Frame similar to data frame pertaining to control of the current wireless transmission. Like suppose this is the range of a particular wireless device. Let's say this is your wireless device. Okay, this is a wireless device and there are many devices connected to this or within in this range. So suppose somebody enters into this range, some other device entered into this range, right? So how to manage all those things? Means who is connected to this network, who is coming out from this network, and who is entered into the network immediately. So those things are controlled by a manager frame. So if you remember mobile IP concept of a wireless network, generally whenever a mobile comes from one network to other network, what will happen? Okay, so there are some frames are transmitted between the member, or not the member, the foreign agent, we can say. If this is the home network for a mobile device, when this mobile device moves to a foreign network, some information gets transferred between both of them. Okay, those are called the manager frames. Second one is a control frame. So what is the control frame? Frame controlling access to the medium similar to the modem's analog connection control mechanism with its request to send, clear to send and acknowledgement. For an example, these two persons want to communicate with each other. Let's say this device want to send some information to this. So the medium is one where he wants to send the data. So if you remember that whenever MAC address concept, when you want to send the data, then you need to acquire the medium. Okay, so you have to send a request, that is called request to send, to access the medium. And when you get the acknowledgement, yes, you can free to access the medium, then you will use the medium to send the data. So those are the called the control frames. And the third one is called data frame. This is the actual data which defines the network traffic over there. So data frames is the actual data you are sending through the wireless medium. Got it? Now let us think about some wireless components. What are the different components needed to make a wireless network? Okay, so there are two components. One is called wireless access point, another is called wireless client device. Right? So wireless access point, as I have already discussed, this is something like in the first figure, I have already discussed that. So if you see this one, so this is a wireless access point. Okay. And wireless access point provides a range. Whenever a device comes to that range, he can access the services provided by the wireless client. Okay. So wireless access point provides connectivity between wireless client devices and the wire network. This is a good device supported by Cisco. So those devices are called 1800, 2800, 3800 routers. These routers nowadays come with a access, means high speed wireless interface card, that is called HWIC. So if you see this device, on the back side of this device there is a port where you can directly insert a device with wireless points. So this device can be inserted into this port to make this router a access point, that is a router with access point cards. So this card will be inserted in the port of this particular device, right? So it now act as a access point over there, wireless access point. So this facility is provided by the Cisco routers. right? Then the second one is called wireless client devices. Those includes user workstations, laptops, PDAs, wireless IP phones. So you know all those things because everything you are using, these are the devices which are used to access the wireless clients. So more on this you can read from the book itself. Okay, so this is a reading assignment for you, this part. This is the reading assignment. You try to explore the user workstation, laptops, PDAs and wireless IP phones. Well, now we'll discuss something about wireless security. Okay, so what is wireless security? Obviously, either it be wired or it may be wireless. We need to give some security facility to this network. But although security was originally included in 802.11 standard, it soon becomes obvious that it was enough. Wireless security, or the lack of it, has been a major contributor to IT managers' reluctance to adopt wireless LANs. But recently, wireless security has improved dramatically and providing IT managers with an acceptable level of comfort to proceed with the installation of wireless LANs. IEEE 802.11i, released in June 2004, addresses current security concerns. So nowadays, whatever wireless devices you see, they are addressing the current security scenarios. Means they are handling the current security scenarios. In addition to 802.11 suites of standard, the 802.1x standard can be used for wireless security. More precisely, 802.1x addresses the port-based access controls. Okay. So nowadays, whatever wireless access devices you are seeing, those providing your providing your security concerns too. So what are the issues in wireless security? So the main issue with wireless communication is unauthorized access to the network traffic. That is the main issue, right? So other points we have discussed here, more specifically we'll discuss all those things. Okay, so generally what happened, unauthorized access means what? Unauthorized access means the watching, displaying and logging of network traffic, also known as sniffing. Okay, sniffing means you are logging or you are watching or displaying the content unauthorizedly. Contrary to a wired network where hackers would need to be physically located at the corporate premises to gain access through a network drop with a wireless network, the intruder can access networks from a location outside the corporate building. Wireless LAN uses radio frequencies and their signal propagates through ceilings and walls. Therefore, wireless eavesdropping, known as war driving and walk by hacking. Okay, the ROG WAP, unauthorized WAPs that allow a hacker access to a network, are two significant security issues with wireless network. Another point is also there. Moreover, wireless equipment tend to ship with open access, not only in traffic propagated in clear text, but wireless WAPs also voluntarily broadcast their identity, known as service set identifier. So what is an SSID? So SSID, whenever you are suppose you are in your college and you go to your home and suddenly you want to switch on your Wi-Fi and you can see the lots of Wi-Fi devices name appear over there, those are called the SSID. And if you want to connect to a particular Wi-Fi device, then you need to provide some security access or security code, then you will be able to connect it. So that means the SSID are openly distributed, means it is openly available. So if somebody gets the SSID, they can try to access those network too. So that is the security issues involved in your wireless network, right? The next part is called wireless threat mitigation. So in default mode, the wireless access is open and we can join it from any place. However, this restricted access is not advisable for corporate networks. So wireless network security can be classified into three categories. One is called basic wireless security, enhanced wireless security, wireless intrusion detection system. So these three parts we'll discuss in the next class. We'll start from basic wireless security. So basic wireless security is basic wireless security is provided by the following built-in functions. One is called SSID, wireless equivalent privacy, media access control, address verifications. This part we'll discuss in the next class. This is the fundamental part, so there is nothing to worry about it. You can read from the book. It is quite easily written on the book itself. That's all for today. Thank you.